Stem cell therapy, some have called it the gift of science. Others say it's sort of like playing God. Now, this kind of procedure is not totally new to the Philippines. Some famous personalities have admitted to undergoing the procedure to help them look young and stay sharp. Among them, former President Joseph Estrada and former Senate President Juan Ponce Enrile. But it has been at the center of heated debates in recent years. How safe is it? Is it a scientifically proven kind of regenerative medicine, or do the risks outweigh the promised benefits?
Now, yesterday we reported about several foreign doctors found to have been conducting stem cell therapies in stand-up clinics and even hotels here in the country. The procedures are quite expensive, but more than that, the question is the procedure safe at all? Tony.
And to discuss this with us, we are joined here in the studio by Dr. Levi John Lansangan. He's one of the founding members of the Philippine Stem Cell Society. On the line, we'll be talking to the president of the Philippine Medical Association, Dr. Leo Olarte.
You can, of course, join a discussion by sending us your comments and questions through Twitter using the hashtag Primetime, or post them on our Facebook page. That's ANC247. Dr. Lansangan, good evening to you, and thanks for joining us tonight. Yes.
Thank you very much, Dr. Lansangan, and also Dr. Olarte. Thank you for joining us on the line. We'll get to you later. First of all, you'd like to talk to our guest here in the studio. So, Dr. Lansangan, when you founded the Philippine Stem Cell Society, you were doing so because you knew at some point that this would become a very commonplace medical procedure.
Yes.
That you needed some way to self-regulate. Is that how you formed it?
Oh yes, I joined the Philippine Society of Stem Cell Medicine because it's the first society that regulated this practice of stem cell. We all know that stem cell has a very big promise in our country, mm-hmm. Because we are now entering a new phase of medicine. Before, it's only physiologic. Then it becomes pathologic, which deals with diseases. And then it becomes pharmacologic, wherein we give medicines to patients. But now it's regenerative, okay. Wherein the body heals by itself.
Yeah.
So in this case, this is a very big potential in our country, the new phase which is called regenerative medicine.
All right. And of course, when you're banded together in a society, in a medical society, you have to look out for unacceptable practices so that your fellow members can avoid doing something which may be medically unethical or unprofessional.
Oh yes, that's right. Foreign doctors are not allowed to practice in our country. Mm. This is already regulated by the Board of Medicine, by the Philippine Medical Association. Mm. Dr. Leo Olarte could speak more about that topic. And doing it in hotels, which is very unsanitary condition.
Right. Yeah.
There is no asepsis, there is no antisepsis, so you're very prone to infection. Mm-hmm. It's all against the regulation posted by the DOH in its website.
Okay. So, in fact, your society will help to police the industry or the practice by pointing out, or trying to reject these medical professionals from coming into the country and doing these unregulated activities.
Yes, that's right. It is a truly coordinated effort by DOH, FDA, and also by the Philippine Medical Association.
Mm.
Doctors in the Philippines should be protected and should be the only one to practice the stem cell therapy.
Yeah.
Okay, let me go to Dr. Olarte now, who's joining us on the phone. Dr. Olarte, good evening to you, and thanks for joining us tonight.
Good evening, Carmen, and for your viewers, and it's the best Dr. Leo Olarte of the Philippine Medical Association.
Right. Now, Dr. Olarte, to the uninitiated, they all feel that it's just a matter of injecting a patient with the stem cell, that's all that's being done here. That's why I guess it's okay for them to go to hotel rooms or go to stand-up clinics for this procedure. Tell us, please. What's the procedure like?
I will come again. I'm here from Santiago City, and I did not hear clearly the question. Will you please repeat the question?
Can you tell us how exactly the procedure is done? Because to some, they all feel that, you know, it's just a matter of injecting the stem cell into a patient.
Oh, I see. The procedure.
Yes.
The procedure. The procedure in doing stem cell treatment is that this is surgical in character. So it means to say that the patient must be prepared in a manner that is clean, and so that infection will not set in. Or if there is an infection, the minimum possibility of infection will be can set in up. So the patient has also to be seen by an anesthesiologist, and must be monitored by the anesthesiologist. And then up cells are removed from, usually we do mesenchymal cell treatment, is we remove the cells from the belly of the patient, and then after removing the cells, the fat cells, we separate the fat cells from the stem cells by use of a machine, a centrifuge and some processing. And after that, we re-inject that, we re-infuse it back to the patient. And this procedure will be about 3 to 4 hours long.
So it is a very tedious process, and that's why you were concerned a while ago, Dr. Lansangan, and that some of these foreign doctors come here to the country and perform this procedure in hotel rooms and stand-up clinics.
Yes.
It's a four-hour procedure.
Yes. Actually, sometimes it lasts around 8 hours.
Depending on the patient?
Yeah. It depends upon the amount of stem cell that you have to harvest. Mm. For example, in our center wherein we harvest the bone marrow, it takes us around 4 to 5 hours to complete the whole procedure. We all know nowadays that there are a lot of sources for stem cell, but the only sources approved by the DOAs are coming from the bone marrow, the fats, and the blood. Of the patient itself. So it's called an autograft. Okay. They don't recognize xenograft or coming from the animals. This is where the problem lies. People that got injection in the hotels are from the animals, are serum from of rabbits or coming sheep. From black sheep. Yes, that's right. Mm-hmm. Yes.
Mm. I've heard of those black sheep treatments. Yes. I think they were actually popularized in Germany, was it? There were several clinics in Germany offering it?
Yes, it's a very popular in one province in Germany. It's called Dresden, and I've been there.
Dresden.
Yes, I've noticed, observed how they extract the serum or the stem cell from the black sheep and then process it. Mm. The problem with stem cell is that it's a very fragile, and volatile cell that it is, I don't believe that they can preserve it through these vials that they introduce.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yes.
So that you may be getting injected with something that has lost its efficacy, right?
That's right, that's right. Yes. I think it's more of the placebo effect that's getting in.
Yeah. Now, how much would a normal stem cell procedure cost in a hospital, especially for members of the Philippine Stem Cell Society, compared to what they're being offered in these hotels?
It's a little bit cheaper in the hotels, okay, as compared to the tertiary hospitals. Mm-hmm. Like, for example, in Medical City, wherein also I'm a visiting consultant, they offer it for anti-aging at around 1.6 million.
Okay.
Okay, and now, but for the hotel procedures, I think they offer it for 500 to 600,000 pesos.
And that's why people who may be lured to avail of these services are thinking that they could get it at a big discount instead of paying that much for a hospital, but they don't know the risks.
Yes, and not only that, Tony, it's because that we have this kind of colonial mentality wherein if Caucasians go here, they think it's more effective than Filipinos performing the procedure.
Really?
So, yes, it's not actually, because doctors here are properly trained to perform stem cell therapy.
Okay, let me go back to Dr. Olarte now. Mm. Dr. Olarte, who can avail of stem cell therapies? As young as maybe, let's say, a person in her teens or maybe in her 20s? Or should it be just for those who really have ailments? Mm. Dr. Olarte?
Please repeat it. I did not get the question again, please.
I think we need to inject stem cells into our phone network.
I was asking Dr. Olarte, who do you think should be availing of stem cell therapies? Is it, you know, a young person who just wants to maybe keep whatever youth she has, or maybe someone who really has illnesses or is suffering from chronic disease?
I cannot really hear so well. The message is choppy.
Okay, Dr. Olarte, this is what we're going to do. We're going to let you go for the meantime. We're going to try and reestablish our connection with you. But maybe Dr. Lansangan can answer that question for us. Go ahead, doctor.
Okay, now we all know that bone marrow therapy is the gold standard for treatment for leukemia and for lymphoma.
Yes.
Okay, so for cancer, it's already proven. But now the studies are coming in that is very effective for myocardial infarction.
Wow.
Yes, I have several evidence-based medicine studies on me that is very effective for myocardial infarction. So what is it in stem cell or in bone marrow that is effective for these kind of diseases?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So there must be something on it.
Uh-huh.
Okay, the hardest part thing to say to the patient is hopelessness. If you say there you have no hope for your disease, I mean that's terminal and it's very unacceptable for the patient. But with stem cell we're giving hope. Okay? Not hope in a sense that we're just giving some kind of a placebo, but on a hope that there is something really into it that's really big.
Mm.
20 years ago, acupuncture is not accepted in our country.
Right. Ah.
But later on now, it's being accepted that it has very medical potential into it.
It's like mainstream medical therapy already. Mm-hmm.
That's right.
And even chiropractors before really had a hard time, you know.
Gaining acceptance?
Gaining acceptance, yeah, because it wasn't considered mainstream as well.
Yes, that's right. And now this is stem cell because a lot of studies are coming in. It's very effective for joint pains.
Mm-mm.
That's what Tiger Woods, Kobe Bryant underwent.
Yeah.
So it's already proven.
Okay.
So effective for joints, effective for myocardial infarction. Mm-hmm. Now we're getting into anti-aging.
Mm.
So there must be something into it that prevents aging.
But how young should you be? Mm. Is there an age limit here or?
Could you be, say, a 10-year-old patient and be eligible for stem cell treatment? Say, so, I mean, there are kids who actually, as young as 10, who get leukemia, right?
That's right, yes. Okay. In pathologic diseases, there's no age limit.
Right.
Okay?
But if it's for vanity's sake.
Yes, for anti-aging, it's when we're in the hormones decreases. When we reach the age of 40, our hormone decreases. So this stem cell therapy is just a small part of what we call as bioidentical hormone therapy.
Okay.
Wherein females, especially females, the estrogen, the progesterone level decreases.
Right.
So we need to have something there.
To supplement it.
Yeah. If you watch the Oprah Winfrey show, she said that the bioidentical hormone therapy helped her, wherein the other big pharmaceutical firm medicines didn't, right?
Mm-hmm. This is actually what I wanted to ask, because when the price difference comes in, making these hotel treatments more attractive to people because of the cheaper price, is there a likelihood that as we see more and more hospitals adopt stem cell therapy as mainstream practice, that the price can go down from the over 1 million price tag it has now?
I believe so. I believe it will go down. There's a big potential in stem cell. We just need a lot of passionate doctors to bring it down.
Really?
Yes.
So it needs the wider acceptance in the medical community to bring the price down.
Yes.
Get on that?
Yes.
But isn't it more a function of like supply and demand? If the demand is high, then you jack the price up even more, right?
No, actually, if the doctors, pledge for is to help humanity, is always to bring down the prices. It's not always to jack. We are not businessmen to increase the prices.
Because when you talk about it in that light, I mean, how many sick people, how many children do we have here in the country have illnesses and who cannot afford to buy medicine? Basically, some of them just die because they can't afford to buy medicines.
That's
right. But you're saying if we're now entering into this regenerative phase of practicing medicine here, then as you said, this has a lot of potential.
It's a lot of potential.
Mm.
That's right.
Now back to Dr. Leo Olarte, and hopefully our stem cell infusion into our telephone line has helped. But because I hear a busy signal, that means a stem cell did not work on the phone line. It doesn't work on poor telecommunications.
Yes. So back to the to because I'm sure you know of this, that some women and men as well undergo stem cell therapy for vanity's sake. You're saying as much as possible, if there's some sort of hormonal imbalance, that that's the only time when they can avail of such a thing.
I think yes, because if you have a hormonal imbalance, they cannot function well. And I know women, and they have a lot of needs. They they want, you know.
You know, for a man to say that, you must be very confident.
Yes. Actually, you know, they need a lot of, sometimes you need attention, you need to give a lot of things
that. Men need attention too, on different levels.
Yes. And so,
come on, we bear your children. We carry them for 9 months. We suffer through the whole pregnancy. Give us this. Go ahead, doctor.
Yes, it's and I believe hormone has to has some play into it. You know, and helping them increase that good hormone feeling will really help them with their hot flashes and a lot of the side effects.
And as he said that, I just felt
Now, in the medical field in the Philippines, just how many are now certified to administer stem cell treatment?
Actually, it's still a gray area right now because every doctor is also a scientist in stem cell therapy. Stem cell therapy, there is no real training regimen.
None.
There's no training regimen.
So where did you pick it up? I mean, where did you pick up your skills?
Okay, it's like this. A lot of centers in Germany offer this short courses, six months to a year, to train doctors into how to harvest. How to harvest the stem cell. Now you know you can now harvest the stem cell. Now, other centers will teach you how to cultivate and enrich the stem cell.
Okay.
Now, into this, it's really up to you how you apply it to your patients.
Really?
So, yes.
So there's no way that a patient can say or check the doctor's background and say, I mean, this particular doctor has had more success in treating patients with stem cell therapy than other doctors.
Yes. As I said, we are all scientists in this field. Even in the United States, Germany, there is no real doctrine that we have to follow that you should do this.
But when you say that, Dr. Lansangan, are you saying that when you're all scientists, you're all free to experiment with patients?
That's pretty scary.
No, that's not what you mean. Right?
That's not what I mean. Mm-hmm. That's why we are now on the safe side. We don't use sheep. We don't use rabbit serum.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
We don't use embryonic coming from the embryo.
Yes.
We just want autologous graft because we know
from the patient themselves.
Let's just make that clear. What is accepted here in the Philippines as we speak is just the procedure and not certain products.
Yes, not certain products.
Just the procedure of harvesting your own
product
and injecting you with your own.
That's interesting because when Casey mentions not certain products, right? If you see these advertisements and they say, what is it, stem cell capsules or tablets?
Yes. Mm-hmm.
I mean, what are these things?
Okay, now, we all know that stem cell is produced by our own body, right?
Mm-mm.
So taking some supplements actually increases the stem cell production of our body. Okay, so there might be products there, okay, that increases the stem cell production in our body. Really? There are already FDA approved like immunoglobulins that we're injected, and it increases the stem cell production in our body.
Oh, yes. I see. So there is something to these products as they're being advertised.
Yes, yes. But of course, we have to, you know, use our discernment to separate those who are legal from illegal medicines. Yes.
And also as a patient, I guess, warning to them as well, you just don't go in a doctor's clinic and be prepared to be injected right away, because there's some sort, there has to be procedure there as well. The doctor would have to interview you as well, right?
Yes.
And find out as much as he can about what you're feeling and whatever it is that you're ailing from.
That's right. Yes, yes. We have, 10 pages of these medical records that we have to fill up.
Like a questionnaire?
Yes, like a questionnaire. We need to get the past medical history, the present medical history of the patient, what is his feeling, and why do he need stem cell therapy?
Now, yes. Just I think days before this interview, there was a huge controversy about, you know, some lawmakers dying allegedly because they had stem cell therapy done.
I heard that in newspapers.
Is that really possible?
Yes, if you develop allergic reaction from this rabbit or from this black sheep serum, yes.
But not from your own.
Not from your own. You don't develop allergic reaction from your own
serum. So you're pretty safe with that.
Autograft is the safest.
But what if, let's say you have cancer and the stem cell that was injected in you also had some cancer cells in it?
Okay. Now, when you have leukemia or lymphoma, wherein the problem is on the bone marrow itself, the process is that we harvest the bone marrow first, okay? And then kill all the cancer cells and then inject it back, okay? So the cancer cells are already filtrated before it is being injected back. Okay, so that's the whole procedure.
All right. Of course, now that you're, it's a new frontier for medical science.
Yes.
Although as more and more medical professionals like yourself adopt it and becomes commonplace, hopefully it does become more acceptable and more affordable for people, so that they don't risk going to these hotel treatments.
Yes.
Right.
Yes.
All right.
That's right.
Well, we would have wanted Dr. Leo Olarte to join us, but unfortunately, stem cell therapy does not work on poor telecommunications, so we couldn't hear him. So in the meantime, Dr. Levi Lansangan, we appreciate it. You came over. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, Tony. Yep.
Thank you
so much. Thank you.